been in a wreck.
Okay. Where you at, hon?
I don't really know. Somewhere in Brownsville, I think.
Okay. Do you know what's your beside?
There's trees everywhere.
Okay. What kind of building are you next to? Do you see anything close?
The high school.
The high school? So are you in the parking lot or in front of the high school? Where?
In front of the high school.
Okay. Are you on Wildcat Way?
I think so.
Okay. How many vehicles are involved?
One.
One? Okay. How many people do you got with you?
Three besides me.
Okay. So four?
Yes.
Okay. Is anybody trapped?
Don't really know.
Okay. Do you see anybody?
Yes.
Okay, where are they at?
They're on the ground.
Okay, so you think they've been ejected?
Yes.
Okay, one, two, how many?
Possibly all three.
Okay. What's your name?
Alex.
Alex what?
Lavelle.
What's your phone number?
7995-5274.
7995-5274?
Yeah.
Okay, is the roadway blocked?
Yes.
Okay, and I'll get everybody out there for you, okay?
Alright, thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Everybody, you can wait 10 minutes. 1333.
You the driver? What's wrong? How are you? You okay? Good head? What happened? Everyone happy? Are you hurting anybody? What's your name? You got anything with you? You had a lot of something at all?
Move it off.
102.
Stay right there.
1041, not breathing. 1047 on 103, 410, Lincoln. Vehicle check on 103, 410, Lincoln, 1334. Brownsville, 404. Speed dial is 102. Advising 102, not breathing, not breathing. 1313. 404, 1335. 1335.
This is the driver, 273, he's got a little bit of a hurt. He's frustrated, just really frustrated.
400 on 1336. Brownsville, 401. 30 possible rejections. 402, Brownsville, 1337.
I
38.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I
24. Brownsville 104.
Where?
Welcome to the United.
Yeah, baby.
What you have witnessed today was a staged accident that can be very real. We have worked several of these instances just like this with kids your age. In 1993, there was an accident on Highway 259 North, just above where the ambulance service is now. There were six kids, about 18 to 25, killed in an accident at one time. So don't think that it can't happen to you. Drinking and driving, this is what you get. You can drive recklessly without being impaired by alcohol. This is what you get. So the point we were trying to make is take care of yourself, be safe. Drugs can be the same thing as alcohol. You may not think that you're impaired, but you can be. If you had trouble talking, had trouble walking, had trouble seeing straight, don't get behind the wheel of a car. If you have to call law enforcement, you have to call mom and dad, you have to call your next door neighbor to come and get you. It's a whole lot better for somebody to go to the middle of the night and come pick you up and bring you home than to come to the accident scene in the middle of the night and watch you either go onto a helicopter flying to Louisville or Nashville or going in the back of a hearse. This does happen. We see this a lot of times. This is a reenactment. You see one that we responded, we stayed for times in here pretty good. If you're in the south end or the north end of the county, they would have been laying here probably 15, 20 minutes before anybody got there to help you. Even if they're still alive after the accident, 15 or 20 minutes, maybe not. Maybe not. So you can take care of yourself better than anybody else can. We can tell you, we can preach to you, we can argue with you, we can tell you why, but you have to make the commitment yourself not to get in this situation. There are accidents that happen that you can't avoid, but drinking and driving accidents, everybody, there's no reason that a drinking and driving accident ever has to occur. They can always be avoided. They can always be avoided. So, see what happens? And this is kind of realistic too. We had one that was killed, one that may not live, that's flew out, and the guy that was drinking and having a good time, he gets to go to jail. He's not hurt too bad, but he has to live with what he done. He killed that young lady. By driving drunk, he took her life. And he has to live with that the rest of his.
I'm Officer Sexton with the Brownsville Police Department. I just want to say, as you go into the problem this weekend, remember what you saw here today? This man that does happen. Think responsibly, be responsible. If you see somebody drinking and driving, well, don't let them drink and drive. Take their keys, drive for them. This is supposed to be a momentous thing that you're following. When you get older, you look back on your life, you want to remember it. You don't want to remember it for something like this. You want to remember something that was a great time to enjoy. Just be careful out there, okay? First of all, let's give these folks a big round of applause for coming out here today. I'm not going to try to name everybody off individually, but we do want to thank each and every one of them. As he said, we've got a big weekend coming up. Pretty much a big month. Got graduation coming up after that. I've been really, really lucky since I've been here as principal in not having to deal with a great deal of tragedy. I feel very lucky and very blessed because of that. When I first moved back from college, I'll tell you a little story. When I first moved back in 19... I'll just put it that way. I was hired to coach at the middle school while I was still in college. And Mr. Cassidy over at the middle school, the principal of the middle school, was one of the people that I coached. That's how old I am. Yeah. He's being mean to me, but I am actually older than him. Anyway, I coached some of those kids for 2 years, and I hate to tell it, but very close to my house, within sight of my house, there's a cross on the side of the road where one of those guys that I coached got killed on New Year's Eve in 1992, I think. And I can remember walking out on my porch, and I can remember seeing the lights over there just like this. Yeah, it was dark that night. And I can remember them coming over to my house, scared to death, because I thought it was somebody in my family. I had no idea this kid didn't even look close to me. He was on his way to see his girlfriend or on his way back for him. But I was out when his mama showed up. One of the scary ones. It's something that actually my parents had on the back of my neck today, just to think about it. So, all the information that they've given you today, the stories that they've told you, what you've seen a scaled back version of what it would actually be. You can't imagine the words telling you the sorrow comes across in a situation like this. So please, please be very careful this weekend. Make good choices. Be careful. Don't do anything that would cause you harm or cause anybody else harm. Mr. Talley, is there anything else? Ms. Lisa? Okay.
We want to recognize the students, Alex, Brandy, Rachel, and Ethan. They've done a wonderful job.
I would have done that, but let me lay a couple of things out to you.
Here we go. Once you show up.
Hey, okay, I don't need this.